Hi students, how are you all doing? We are continuing with our classes on water soluble vitamins, and today's topic is vitamin B2, that is riboflavin. Now this is the structure of riboflavin. There is a dimethyl isyloxazine ring and there is ribitol in the structure, but let me tell you don't need to remember the structure of riboflavin. It will never be asked, right? But this you need to know. The active principle, what are the active coenzyme forms of riboflavin, that is important. And it is FMN, flavin mononucleotide, and flavin adenine dinucleotide. So FMN and FAD, right? From riboflavin, flavokinase enzyme catalyzes the formation of FMN with use of one ATP, right? ATP to ADP, so one phosphate group is used. And from FMN to FAD, ATP and PPI, so this adenine group now goes inside, right? So AD goes inside. So here kinase, that is phosphate group, and here adenine group is gone, right? So generation of FMN and FAD with the help of ATP. Very important, both of these reactions need ATP, but seldom you will see ATP is used and the compound is not utilizing the high energy phosphate bond. This is one example of such reaction. ATP is used, but the high energy phosphate bond is still remaining intact in this pyrophosphate, right? This you need to remember. Again, this is the structure of flavin mononucleotide and flavin adenine dinucleotide. You don't need to remember unless you are preparing for AIMS and other competitive USMLE exams. Over there, image based questions are given, and then you definitely need to identify this one from all other options. But as first year undergraduate, you can simply skip the structure. Of course, it will have the parent riboflavin along with adenosine, right? So this is the ring of FAD, and this is FADH2, right? Often in all the reaction that uses FADH2 as reducing equivalent, it will be converted from FAD to FADH2. So here the two hydrogen bonds, hydrogen atoms are attached. This is an MCQ question, image based question, and just remember these two positions. Basically, they are attached to two free nitrogens, right? Very easy to remember. We move on to one very important thing, that is the semiquinone form. The conversion of FMN to FMNH2 or FAD to FADH2 undergoes in a two-step manner. One is semiquinone, where it is half reduced, right? So one lone pair of electron remains over here. See, this is H dot, means one lone pair of electron is there. The reaction is not fully completed. Fully when it is completed, when both the hydrogen are attached and it forms FMNH2 or FADH2. So remember, semiquinone form is important. It is also the question for you guys who are watching, what are the other compounds in biochemistry you have read where semiquinone forms are present? I'll give you one example, that is ubiquinone in electron transport chain. I've already explained that, right? It's a homework for you guys. Please comment in the comment section what other semiquinone forms you are aware of, right? So this is why we are studying this. FAD, riboflavin, FMN, these are all coenzymes, right? So what are the enzymes that are dependent on riboflavin? Very important, amino acid oxidation, right? During amino acid oxidation, FMN is reduced, right? And it's also used in the respiratory chain, complex 1, right? Very, very, very important. So two regions, amino acid oxidation and respiratory chain, if you are allowed to tell only one, always tell this one, right? Respiratory chain, electron transport chain, complex 1, very important. Over there, that is the most important use for FMN, FADH2 for first year undergraduate students. Anyway, so let us learn few names. Now see, all of these are important. If you are attempting for an honors or very good distinction marks, as also and also MCQs, you need to remember each and every one of them. But I'll just read them and you can choose to remember any two or three for a good marks in Viva. So succinate to fumarate by succinate dehydrogenase is an enzyme of TCA cycle. Must remember, right? See, I will tell all of them are must remember because it's easier for me to remember, but you can choose which one is easier for you. Next, acyl CoA 2, unsaturated, right? This acyl CoA dehydrogenase, this is an enzyme of fatty acid synthesis. Now, there is a concept that you need to remember. Whenever these dehydrogenases are converting a compound from saturated to unsaturated, see, this is what happens. Suppose hydrogen, right? It will be converted to this double bond, right? From acyl CoA to unsaturated acyl CoA. Unsaturation means a double bond inserted, right? So, FADH2 dependent dehydrogenase always grabs hydrogen from adjacent carbon atoms. So, these two hydrogen will be removed and one double bond will be inserted. In contrast, when I will be discussing niacin, NAD dependent dehydrogenase, what do? They actually grab hydrogen from same carbon atom. Very important concept. Here we are discussing FAD, remember, adjacent carbon atoms. From adjacent carbon atoms, hydrogen will be extracted during this dehydrogenase. So, all FAD dependent dehydrogenase extracts hydrogen from adjacent carbon atoms. Then xanthine to uric acid by xanthine oxidase, very important. This is a question of allopurinol enzyme gout treatment, you need to remember. Pyruvate to acetyl CoA, FAD is a cofactor. PDH reaction, link reaction, three enzymes, five cofactors, you can remember. If you remember PDH, you can also remember alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, same complex type of enzyme, right? So these you can choose to remember one from these five, fine. Next, retinol to retinoic acid by cytosolic retinol dehydrogenase, and then 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate, tryptophan to niacin. These are not that important compared to these five. Okay, these five are must remember, to be honest, right? Because you need to remember these cycles anyway on these pathways. Next, we are looking at riboflavin deficiency. So, you will be asked what are the symptoms of riboflavin deficiency. In general, vitamin B complex deficiency, angular stomatitis, a lesion at the angle of mouth, glossitis means red, beefy tongue, chilosis means cracked lip. This is actually due to the riboflavin component. So, all the symptoms of vitamin B complex deficiency are manifested due to riboflavin deficiency. So, these are features that will be visible from outside. These are the features by which patient will report to you, and you in general will give a vitamin B complex tablet which will have riboflavin, and all these will be healed up. So, glossitis means inflammation of the tongue, red beefy tongue, chilosis, chapped lips, angular stomatitis over here, okay, and then circumcorneal vascularization. You can choose to remember just these three in general, but remember circumcorneal vascularization is very important. The cornea reddens and there will be blood vessels visible around the cornea. Again, a sign of riboflavin deficiency. Rest you can choose to remember, but you must remember the highlighted ones, right? So you see circumcorneal vascularization, see redness around the cornea, very important. Whole eye becomes red, as if you have splashed your water eye with cold water or you have anything hit the eye. This is beefy red tongue, glossitis, right? And these are the angular stomatitis, right? And also irregular ridges in nails. Often you will see this one, the last one. You can almost find this in your nails even, right? My nails also have got some ridges, but they are irregular. It's not regular. Ridges are normal, but irregular ridges are signs of riboflavin deficiency. So, what are the dietary sources of riboflavin? In general, meat, fish, egg, liver, right? Whole grains, legumes, vegetables, whatever you can think of. If you tell something or the other will hit your answer. It means all of them contains riboflavin, thankfully. So, mainly concerned with metabolism of carbohydrates, because you saw all these enzymes, the first five mainly are carbohydrate metabolism enzymes, right? This one is vitamin, this one is nucleotide metabolism, and this one is amino acid metabolism. Majority is carbohydrates, right? So, it's concerned with metabolism of carbohydrates. So, if you take more carbohydrate in diet, you need more riboflavin to metabolize all those things, right? Generally, requirement is 1.5 mg per day. don't need to remember. And one thing is important, generally true for all nutrients in pregnancy and lactation, the requirement will almost invariably increase. So that's it for today's video, right? Not much to remember, but it's very important, especially the enzymes of carbohydrate metabolism and the respiratory electron transport chain, where FMN is used as cofactor, and this reaction by which riboflavin is converted to FMN and FAD, and the semiquinone form, that you need to remember. Other than that, it's over, riboflavin, and we will continue our lesson on next water soluble vitamins, and I will see you soon with another video. Till then, bye and take care.